Hi, let's see how to monitor Azure Stack HCI with Azure Monitor HCI Insights. This is an HCI cluster which is already registered on the required OS version and has managed identity enabled. Under Nodes, you can see all the nodes are ARC enabled, which enables it to provide powerful management capabilities like Insights. On clicking on Insights, you are redirected to the welcome screen. Click on Get Started. A right pane opens. Here the customer can either choose from a bunch of existing data collection rules or create a new data collection rule. DCR specifies the event logs and performance counters which are required to light up Insights workbooks. Let's give a name to the DCR. Azure Stack HCI will be prepended to the rule name, which helps in identifying the DCRs created by Microsoft. Data collection endpoint is used to access the configuration service to fetch associated DCRs for AME. You can select from existing ones or create a new one. Choose from your existing subscriptions and resource groups or create a new one. The events and perf counters are stored in a log analytics workspace. You can select the resource group you want the workspace to be created in, or select an existing log analytics workspace. Click on Review plus Create. You'll be redirected to the final screen, which will give you a summary of the performance counters, the Windows event logs, the log analytics workspace, the name of the DCR that will be created. Click on Setup. You'll be redirected to the Extensions page, where you can see the Azure Monitor Windows Agent will be installed on all the nodes of the cluster. After a while, navigate to Monitor, Azure Stack HCI, and you will be able to monitor your cluster along with other clusters. At the first glance, I know the health status of my clusters. For this cluster, you can see there's a critical health fault for a server and a physical disk. If you click on the cluster name, you'll be redirected to Insights workbook for that single cluster and give you more detailed information about the health faults, the faulting resource ID, the severity, and the fault time. The Servers tab gives information like servers under the cluster, the server health, the server state, the uptime for those servers, the CPU usage and the memory usage. You can also drill down further for details like RDMA or non-RDMA data. The third tab, Virtual Machines, shows the status of the VMs within a cluster, the number of VMs running, if VM has been running or stopped or failed. The last tab, Storage, gives information about the total storage capacity and the available storage capacity. It tells about the health of the volume by metrics like IOPS, throughput, and latency. Now let's talk about customization. Already provided workbook templates can be easily customized. These workbook templates are grouped together. So first edit will customize the whole template, and then you need to click edit again to customize a specific chart. As you can see, SCUSA Query provides a visualization for a line chart. There are different visualizations available for workbooks like grid view, area chart, bar chart, pie chart, scatter chart, graphs, and much more. You can select from either of them. You can also collect additional data like new events or perf counters. To do that, go to Monitor and edit the data collection rule that we associated with this cluster. Go to Data Sources. If you want to see logs related to the failover clustering diagnostics event channel, add that event channel. Give destination as the workspace. Once the events start flowing, customize the workbook and edit the visualization you want to change. Now let's edit the CUSTA query. For instance, if we want to create a chart if the cluster service is running or not, we will add the failover clustering event channel. We just added this event channel to the data collection rule. An event ID 2049 is logged when the cluster service is running. And no events are logged if the service is not running or cluster is unhealthy. Now let's filter it down further using the cluster arm ID or the node name. So in any given hour, if event 2049 exists, we will make a series with a variable cluster availability and set the value to 1 if any event is logged, which means it is running, or else as 0 if no event is logged for event ID 2049. Now we are giving a time range. And generated the series for every hour. Once the processing is done, we will project the time generated and the variable that we just created. Now let's make some visualization changes. Let's give the legend value as maximum value and color as green. If the value is 1, it shows that the cluster is available. And if the value is 0, it shows that the cluster service was not running at that particular time. Now let's change the graph name. Once the desired changes are made, let's save the workbook and give workbook a name. Apply the changes. You'll be able to see that this new graph is part of your already available template. This is how easy it is to collect new logs and customize workbook templates. Data collected can also be used to set up alerts. For instance, if you want to set up alert when memory usage reaches a particular threshold, go to Insights Workbook, edit the query. For creating an alert for the memory usage, I will prepare the memory usage variable and convert it to an integer so that it can be used as a measure in alerts. Once the variable is prepared, I will project the variable so that it appears in the result and hence in the measure dropdown and click on New Alert Rule. From the measure dropdown, select the memory usage variable, give aggregation type as maximum. Split by is an optional field. It provides information based on the property that's given in the split by dimensions. So if you want to get notified using the server arm ID, select that. You can further specify the dimension names, like the node name. In the alert logic, you can select the threshold value and see the changes in the preview below. So the preview shows that the current values are approximately at 25, whereas the threshold value where we want to set an alert, it's 80. Select an action group, which can be an email or an event hub link, You can also integrate 3P alerting solutions like PagerDuty. Give the alert rule name, description, click Review plus Create, and finally Create. Go to Monitor, Alerts, and you can see the alert rule that we created. For the purpose of this demo, I've already created an alert and have been notified with the email. This is how the alert email looks like: the alert rule name, the resource type, the dimension name, and the threshold value. You can click on the alert from the email and disable the alert or perform the required remediation. This way, you can create any type of custom alerts. In future, we will provide simple graphical user interface for setting up alerts which will not be dependent on writing Kusta queries. That's just a quick look at what we can do with Azure Stack HCI Insights. Thank you.